I realize that cheese and crackers doesn't really count as a meal. Probably should have gone to the grocery store, but if you want to go to a restaurant, you know, maybe somewhere with food, we can always do that.
No, I think that this is a perfect spot for lunch. It's nice and warm by the fire, and there's no prying eyes watching over us. Except for hers, of course.
Ah, yeah, but she's not bombarding us with questions the way Ewan does. Who is your roomie, by the way?
I'm not sure. He said he had to work.
Oh, he found something more interesting than you.
Oh, and the problem that can't be solved. I'm sure that's an endless source of frustration. I mean, I'm not surprised that Ewan needs a break every once in a while.
I'm sure his fascination outweighs his frustration.
Why are we spending our time talking about Dr. Keenan? And we could be doing so many other things.
Like what? Like what do you have in mind, huh? Mm-hmm. Oh, anybody who says nothing good happens at Windermere couldn't be more wrong.
Think again, Dodge. Luke Spencer.
I'm Cassandra.
Cassandra, lovely name. What brings you to Spoon Island? Are you a big fan of Dungeons and Dragons?
Privacy. Actually, something that seems very hard to come by around here.
Well, this decrepit old mausoleum is hardly a place to look for solace. Too many lost souls wandering around these halls.
Yeah, too many lost souls wandering into this room.
I'm actually talking about the ones who drew their last breath on this island. Catherine Bell, Emily Quartermain, even old Vlad himself, to name but a few. I'll bet the real estate agent didn't clue you in on the body count before they rented the place. If you haven't guessed from all the gargoyles, the Cassadines were a pretty twisted bunch.
I'm not afraid of ghosts.
Well, Helena isn't dead. Not that I haven't tried to make her so.
Helena Cassadine. There seems to be a healthy obsession with her and your family.
The obsession is mutual, believe me.
Yeah, look, why don't we skip the history lesson for today, okay? We'll save it for another time.
I'm just trying to let your young friend know what she's in for here.
Well, there's something to be said for a little mystery. I'm gonna go see what other food I can scare up.
You're cute.
Oh, I thought so.
What the hell was that?
Just trying to get to know your mystery woman a little better, something that I suggest you do.
I already know everything I need to know about her.
Oh, I seriously doubt that. It baffles me how you can be so adept at running a con and so inept when it comes to women.
I think I take exception to that.
Oh, really? How about your initial foray into the perils of matrimony?
Oh, come on, leave Maya out of this, all right? That didn't even count.
It didn't? You jumped in with both feet and got your heart stomped there.
Yeah, that was for money. Then love, but this is different, okay? Yeah,
okay, what? What's different about it? You're skipping the money part and going right for the love?
No, Cassandra's not like anyone I've ever met.
Well, I don't doubt that. She's a blank slate. A beautiful woman with no memories. She's an empty canvas on which you can paint your fantasies.
Yeah, I've never considered myself much of an artist.
Well,
okay, but hey, maybe I'm leaving myself open to possibilities.
Yeah, well, just do yourself a favor. And slow down. Don't jump in any harder.
Look, I am out here having a perfectly great time trying just to get to know Cassandra, and you have to waltz in and ruin everything?
All I'm doing is asking her some questions, which apparently you hadn't planned to do.
Yeah, maybe I don't want to know who she was before I met her.
Well, I can guarantee you this. People don't try to block out happy memories. It's only darkness and despair they try to run away from.
Oh, my God. Look, Cassandra's not hiding some deep, dark secret, okay? She just doesn't remember who she was.
Yes, and that's exactly what concerns me.
I give you plenty of space to go make your own mistakes. Now, all I ask is that you return the favor, okay? Can you do that for me?
I'm not trying to tell you how to run your life. I'm just asking you to proceed with a little caution.
My life, okay? I'm gonna proceed however I choose.
Dodge, you're my son. I love you. You didn't live here when everything Cassadine was pure poison to every Spencer they could get their hands on. Anybody who wants to live in this graveyard is asking for misery.
Look, the Cassadine legacy on this island is over. Okay, they're all dead or moved on. Now let's close that book. I want to start a new chapter here.
If this were a game of poker, you would have already lost the farm. I mean, here you are. You don't even know this woman. You put all your cards on the table, face up. What the hell has happened to you? Suddenly, this mysterious woman walks into your life. You throw caution to the wind. You put all your chips on the table. I don't get it.
Look, maybe I want to go for broke, okay? Cassandra's an amazing woman.
Yeah, an amazing woman that you know nothing about. Now, what happens if she suddenly does remember her past? I mean, what happens if there's some spud out there that she's got history with? Maybe even a family. You are going to be out in the cold.
Yeah, that's exactly why I don't want to waste time with what ifs. Right, look, I mean, maybe she will remember at some point, okay? But until then, I am enjoying what's happening right now. If there's one thing I learned from you, it's how to live in the moment. Now let me do that, okay? Now if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go find my mystery woman. I believe you know the way or ways out. We'll see. I am impressed with your culinary skills. There are only 3 edible items in that pantry. Maybe you used to be a chef.
No, I have a feeling you're just as resourceful. Something you undoubtedly got from your father?
Yeah, sorry about that. That was embarrassing.
Oh, no, I didn't mind. I find him quite interesting.
I guess that's one word for it.
Yeah. He seems to be just as drawn to this place as I am.
You know what you said earlier about the obsession? It's true. My family and the Cassadines have been at war for, decades. And Helena seems hell-bent on dragging our generation into it.
So are you intending on taking the responsibility? Carrying on the family tradition?
No. No, I'm a lover, not a fighter.
Prove it.